عندنا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طبعا نبدو على بركة الله أو المحاضرة الثالثة طبعا في مادة علاج تحفظي، طبعا مادة تراد متفرويش. طبعا إن شاء الله تكون موفقين طبعا في البرنامج هذا ونوصل المعلومة لأبنائنا الطلاب بكل سهولة. طبعا موضوعنا اليوم هو Fundamental of Tooth Preparation، يعني Fundamental or Principle of Tooth Preparation، معنى أساسيات تحضير الأسنان لكي تقبل حشوة سواء كانت حشوة أمامية أو خلفية. طبعا احنا في السابق تكلمنا على أنواع الكافيتي طبعا، وقلنا الكافيتي مقسم على Two System Classification of Cavity، سواء كان جيفي بلاك طبعا حدد الكافيتي طبعا لستة أنواع من الكافيتي. Glass 1 اللي هو بس أن فيشر في الأوكلوزر سيرفس أوف بوستيريور أو الأوكلوزر تو ثيرد أوف بوستيريور تيث طبعا، والجلاس 2 اللي هو البروكسيمال ميزير أو ديستن في البوستيريور تيث، الجلاس 3 اللي هو الميزال والديستال في الانتيرير تيث مش نوت ان فول اوف الانسايزر ايدج، جلاس 4 ان فول اوف الانتيرير تيث وان فولوفينج ميزال ديستال الانتيرير تيث ان فولوفينج الانسايزر ايدج، جلاس 5 السيرفايكال كافيتي اوف اول ذا تيث. اوكي بالنسبه لي السي سي اي سيستيج كلاسيفيكيشن او سيستا كلاسيفيكيشن، السي اي مينس السايت والسي تي اي ستيج، مع هو وي هاف 5 سايت اند 3 سايت اند 4 ستيل، 3 سايت اند 4 ستيل فور ذا كافيتي، وي هاف 3 سايت اند 4 ستيل. السايت 1 اللي هو الأوكلوزر تو ثيرد of the posterior teeth and palatal surface of anterior teeth، glass 2 البروكسيمال surface of posterior and anterior teeth، glass 3 اللي هو cervical one third of all the teeth either anterior or posterior. We have important to know this classification because when we are dealing for principle of cavity preparation, we have to know that classification. The principle or root of cavity preparation, we have the first mechanical principle. The principle which dealing with the mechanical. The outline of the first one of the mechanical principle is the outline form. We have to put the outline form or do outline form of the cavity to receive the restoration and to receive the restoration. Fundamental rule of the outline form design. Factors modifying the outline form. We have rule for outlining or for designing the cavity, and we have modification that rule for design of the cavity. The second step is the resistance and the retention. Resistance of the cavity is to fracture either the restoration. We put the cavity to resist fracture, either fracture of the restoration or to the tooth structure. And we put the outline of the cavity which make the cavity more retentive. Retention means the resistance of the restoration to dislodgement against the vertical forces. We put the restoration either amalgam or composite static restoration or posterior restoration with amalgam to resist dislodgement when the patient using for chewing or for chewing purpose. So the restoration must be retained into the position without dislodgement. And we have to go for resistance for definition and affecting factors affecting resistant form, resistance forms and types of retention, means of retention and factors affecting the retention. So we have when we able to put the restriction more retentive, we have to do something into the cavity during preparation to make the restoration retain into the cavity without dislodgement. So retention form, it is the retention of the restoration or retaining of the restoration into the cavity without dislodgement. Resist means resist the tooth and restoration to fracture. So we want the outline form to resist the restoration and the tooth from fractures. Part 3, convenience form. Convenience form in any ways, it means that when we put instrumentation to remove caries or either bears or stone or excavators, which we know under the instrument further words. So we have convenience, we bought the cavity, convenience for manipulation restoration with the instrument, or make the cavity into the size of the instrument, which can be used for either condensation or to finishing of the restoration, or for condensation, finishing application, condensation, finishing, or for removal of the caries if there is caries remaining. Introduction for convenience and definition and feature. Removal of the remaining caries dentine. We have to remove any caries lesion beyond the outline, which we have to remove that caries. We have to remove that caries. Part 5, finishing the enamel wall. We have to finish the enamel wall, to planing the enamel wall to receive the restoration without fractures. Objective, requirement of enamel walls, but what we need from the enamel wall. So the enamel wall must be if it is careful surface angle, which we are told into the introduction, that the angle between the outer surface and the inner surface must be right angle to resist the restoration for either to resist the restoration from fracture or the tooth from the fracture. We have to blend that walls. In inner walls, we have to do it as a rounded wall for amalgam, and we have for reduced stress concentration inside the cavity. Factors affecting inclination of careful surface angle, which I mentioned before, just 1 minute before, that is the careful surface angle must be right angle. If it is obtuse or angle, the force will be concentrated into the restorative material, or the restorative machine or hashwa will be fractured. If it is more less than 90 or acute angle, so more acute, the angle must be less than 90, so the tooth structure will be not supported with dentine and the tooth will be fractured. Beveling of enamel wall, we are not do beveling into the occlusal surface either for amalgam or any anesthetic restoration, because the bevel will give little amount of material, and during the use the material will be fractured. So we never to do bevel into the occlusal surface. Okay. Instrument used for finishing. We have to know about the instrument which used for finishing to finish the cavity. A cleaning and toilet cavity, we have to debriment the cavity, or cleaning or toilet cavity, to remove any debris which affect the either for the what resists the seating of the restoration or seating of the beads or liner if we do them protection under the restorative materials. So we have to clean this any debris. We have to clean and make the surface more clean and smooth to receive the restorative materials. Okay. Part 1, we have to do introduction. Introduction, we have to a cavity. It is the defective part of the tooth structure. Defective part of the tooth structure, either due to trauma, fractures, or due to caries, mechanical trauma, or due to the caries, effect of the caries. And from beginning or before we are introduction, we are to have to make the definition of the caries, that the action of bacteria into the sugar, which they produce lactic acid, lactic acid with the concentrated in the creased, so it will do chelation of tooth or removal of the hard obstruction, and the caries will start to initiate. Okay, so the cavity is the defective of the calcified part of the tooth, either due to mechanical trauma, fracture, or any accident or something, dropping down or failing or boxing, or due to caries, Okay, without definite shape and extension. Prepared cavity, the cavity which are preparing after we, when we remove to the caries, so we have to prepare the cavity on both the outline of the cavity to the receive restorative material. Introduction, our traditional first order and simplest mission is the convert the cavity into prepared. So convert the cavity which produced by caries or trauma into the prepared cavity to make it suitable for receiving the restorative material, to make the restorative material resist to fracture or to reinforce the tooth resist to tooth fracture, or to enforce the restorative material to prevent fracture of the restorative material, or prevent the dislodgement of the restorative materials. So this is the instrument we are using. This is the cavity during for the caries. And this is the prepared cavity to this restorative material. Restorative material either amalgam, silver amalgam. We know this amalgam is silver amalgam, which sometimes we go through for the dental materials. And composite, it is static restoration, composite resin, gold or hashwat dahab, GIC, glass ionomer cement, or liner and basin. So this is the material which we bought into the cavity. So we have to design the cavity to make it suitable to receive these materials. This is amalgam, composite, gold, GIC, all these are filling material. Except GIC, sometimes it is basis liners from included with GIC. GIC, it is meant by either filling or basis and liners. And all these four are filling materials. Liner beads which put under the restoration to prevent either thermal or chemical damage to the tooth, either from the effect of these with the thermal conduction, the beads will reduce the thermal action to the pulp, and the liner will seal the pulp and prevent the seepage of any fluid into the dentinal tubule, which makes the problem to the pulp. So we have to do beads and liner and the filling to protect the tooth from either from insulin, either chemical or mechanical or thermal. Okay. Introduction. Instrument, this is what we have to do. Needles and over. Needles for tooth to prepare a cavity in the tooth. What we need? The need. Teeth need restorative intervention for any cavity. We have to do a restorative intervention. Which cavity which need restorative intervention? The cavity onto the surface enable sometimes enamel. Sometimes we have not to do restorative intervention. The cavity which exceeds more than one third of enamel or entering the dentine, we have to do cavity and to do both the restorative material inside, okay, to make the tooth more easily cleaned and finished after the removal of the restorative. So we fill the tooth to prevent further damage or further decay, okay. Repair the tooth after destruction. We have to repair the tooth. The tooth will be destructed with caries. So we have to repair the tooth to prevent further caries progress. Replacement of the repaired restoration with serious defect. So we have to replace or repair of restoration. If we have old restoration, we have to repair that restoration. Or any defective restoration, we have to either to repair it or to replace or repair. static demand of patient to, for example, anterior cheese patient dealing with static. So we have any changes in the restoration into the anterior teeth discolored or dislodged. So we have to replace it to make the restoration more aesthetic or more basic observation to give the patient looks normal, looks normal. We have we make the patient and هو يبدأ طبيعي يعني gain normal aesthetic demand or for the patient. Restore form and to restore we have to restore the form and function. We have to tone the form of the tooth, its shape of the tooth, and the function which makes the patient use the tooth without any defect, without defect of the restoration. So we have to use the tooth without any defect in the restoration. Restoration of occlusion, which it is mandatory to restore the occlusion, to restore or to retain the normal occlusion of the patient, because when there is cavity or the destruction of the tooth, so the tooth may be slightly out of occlusion, we have to retain the occlusal function of the tooth into the normal occlusion without fracture either to the restoration or the tooth structures. Repair of fractured tooth, we have to repair fractured tooth and retain it to the normal situation. Tooth may be restored in a preventive sense. We have to must something other sometimes we have to do restoration to prevent the tooth from further damage. Further damage. Needs objective tooth preparation to remove the defect. Defect cares or any trauma, any part which missing, we have to replace it. Locate the margin, we have to locate the margin of the restoration conservatively as possible. We have to cut what we need. We have not to extend the outline beyond the outline which we needing. So we have more concept to remove the keels and the both the fill to both the filling. We have to remove the keels, both the outline to make more resistance and retention and convenience, and remove the keels. Conserve it. معنى we have to conserve and نكون احتياطيين أو نكون إحنا نحافظوا على amount of tooth structure. So we have any sound tooth structure we have to not to extend the caries or we have not to prepare. For the cavity, in these rules we have either sister classification or GF black. GF black extend the cavity into best and facial for preventive care. So recently we have any preventive means to brushing, fluoride application. So we are not need to do extension for prevention. Okay. For the cavity, so that the tooth or the restoration will not fracture, and we have to put the cavity or restoration the cavity when the flow force applied into the restoration, the tooth and the restoration not be fractured during mastication and during use. Allow for aesthetic, we have to do what the aesthetic, we have not to extend the restoration further to compromise aesthetic, especially for amalgam if it is proximal into the premolars or molars. Okay. Principle tooth preparation, we have three main principles. We have three circles crossing each other evenly. So we are not to put biology over the mechanic or mechanic over biology or aesthetic over biology or mechanic. We have to give even equal distribution. Biology, we have dealing with the gingiva and gingiva latta, and we have dealing with the pulp. We have to do dealing with the pulp and gingiva. So have we have to protect during principle. We have to do principle of fluorization, not to invade the pulp or not to invade the gingiva, not to do harm for the pulp or not to do harm for the gingiva. The mechanical mean that retention form resist form put the cavity out in line to resist dislodgement and to resist fractures static we put the outline of the cavity to make the tooth more static either restoration of the tooth more static principle tooth preservation اللي هي preservation we have biological principle we have to observe the vitality of the tooth we make the tooth vital we make the pulp is healthy we have to preserve the pulp of the teeth become more becomes healthy we have to protect and support mechanical provide maximum resistance before we have the minimum resistance and retention forms Okay, biological principle of we have today we discuss about biology and we into chapter. Biological principle, the steps to be followed to achieve the biological principle of the tooth preparation. Pulp protection, we have to protect the pulp during tooth preparation, during outline form, tooth preparation outline, putting the outline of the cavity during اللي هو tooth preparation or during the replacement of the restorative materials. We have to protect the pulp from mechanical, chemical, and thermal injury. Preservation of prevention of caries recurrence. We have to prevent the tooth from the recurrence of the caries. So we have to put the margin of the restoration to the most feasible part to be easily clean. To be easily clean, self-cleansable or easy cleaned by the patient. Septic working field. We have to work into a septic technique. Though no fluid, no bacteria will contaminate the cavity during preparation. During preparation, so we have to put. Septic technique either to put rubber dam or cotton rolls with the powerful suction to remove the saliva. Okay. Pulpal protection. Mechanical irritation during cavity preparation. The pair rotate around 5,000 revolution per minute. So heat generation will make injury to the bulb if you are not do water cooling. Water cooling during the preparation. We have to mandatory do water cooling during cavity preparation to prevent mechanical irritation or sometimes the beyond outline sometimes when we go to throw the receded area the area which you know, there's no care so when we extend the cavity into that area so maybe go into the pulpal exposure against thermal irritation during the heat generation during tooth preparation we have to do to use water cooling against chemical which we do to either chemical from the restorative material itself or chemical during debridement or twilight of the cavity. We have not to use astringent chemical to go through the dentine tubule or make the harm to the pulp. Okay. Pulpal protection. Avoid direct traumatic and we have to avoid that. How to avoid direct traumatic injury to the pulp? We are not do the cavity, both the cavity to the receded area, the area which with the which there are no caries. With the carry area which there is no caries, so the bulb horn will be high, so possibility of exposure will be more. And we are not use the bear or stone, sharp bear or stone, so make the heat generation more, so we have to if we have to do use the sharp bear or stone we are not use the dull bear or stone okay avoid unnecessary pressure we have not to use excessive pressure because pressure will give the dentine elastic dentine so pressure will harm to the pulp avoid cutting across the recession area the recession area what's the area where the bulb chamber is high we have to cut only into the way where the caries involve okay avoid overcutting of dentine we are avoid to overcutting of the dentine to prevent weakening of the tooth structures avoid sharp line angle must be internal line angle must be rounded to prevent stress concentration and prevent more damage, more pressure into the area, which may either affect the bulb or affect the restorative material or make the restorative material fractures. When the restorative material fractures, so there is a gap, so a fluid will go into the gap and make harm to the bulb. As we see from these pictures, we have to see the pulpal protection. So we are not able, we are not cut through the receded area in this lecture. So we have to cut like this way. We are not to cut to the receded area because we do pulpal exposures. Okay. Here, pulpal protection against that one. We have to use the bear into the direction and we cut into that direction to prevent if we use this excavator like this direction, so we have maybe we injury or harm the pulp. Here we are away, so we can use in that situation to prevent the cutting through the receded area and prevent the damage to the pulp. Okay. Against mechanical radiation, bulb against mechanical radiation, against thermal radiation, and chemical. Bulb protection against thermal irritation. Thermal irritation, they are using the high speed headpiece and there is heat generation, so we have to use the high speed with water cooling, and water cooling as fumes. All the area for cavity prevention or for cutting the tooth, for tooth receive cutting of the tooth by the bear must be moisted with water, as fumes. Bulbal protection. Bulbal protection avoid against chemical irritation. We have failed causal of the chemical during either use chemical one do with toilet or cleaning the cavity or debris the cavity, or chemical from the restorative material either composite which have methyl methacrylic acid or phosphate cement, which sometimes when they are, we are using close to the bulb, so without any protective liner or bases, so sometimes this acid is go through the dentine to be able to use the bulb and make this injury to the bulb, or the chemical which is used for cleaning. Prevention of caries. We have to remove all of caries enamel and we have to remove all caries. We have to remove all caries. So when we remove the caries, so prevent further damage to the tooth or and prevent the damage to the dental bulb. When you remove the caries, we have to ensure that we are not harm the bulb. If there is any caries remaining, so the caries will produce acid. Acid will infect or harm the bulb. Removal of your enamel. The cavity outline should be extended in include. So cavity outline must be extended to include bits and fissures. We have to follow bits and fissures. Bits of it or unfollow with bits and fissures. So we have to follow or unfollow the bits and fissure. Some bits and fissure we have to not include it. So we have in this situation we have to remove caries and we have to put the cavity and make the cavity more retentive. Okay. Prevention of caries recurrence. We have to prevent caries recurrence. Either remove all caries, will not leave any caries into beyond the restoration, or we have to do good adaptation of the restorative material into the cavity wall to prevent leakage of the fluid or bacteria between the leak space to make the recurrent caries under. So we have to either to remove all the caries which under the make the restoration free under restoration free caries, and we have to make good adaptation of the cavity restoration to the cavity wall and make the restoration to the self-cleansable area. Self-cleansable area. Self-cleansable. Make after we make the restoration to have the patient easy to clean over the restoration. Prevention, removal of any underarm enamel must be removed, which when it is weak, so these occlusal forces will fracture and make leaky space and make the recurrent caries. Enamel is not supported by sound until we have to remove it, because under stress will be weakened and will fracture and give the gap between the restoration and the tooth structure, and which produce recurrent caries or secondary care تسوس نوع الأخ ثاني وثانوي. Prevention, proper inclination or cavo surface angle as what you told before, so must be 90 degree. If it is more than 90 degree or obtuse, the restoration will be break, there is a leaky space and there is recurrent caries and maybe will harm the pulp. That if it is less than 90 degree, so the tooth structure will be fracture and there is leaky gap or leaky space, and the insulate reach the bulb and make the harm the bulb or the secondary caries or recurrent caries around the margin of restoration will be reduced. Prevention of caries recurrence, avoiding any sharp line angle which makes stress concentration. We have to make it rounded, line angle must be rounded to prevent the stress restoration, stress concentration, and prevent the fracture of the restoration. Okay. Aseptic working field. We have we do aseptic, so we have not to do any restoration or cavity without isolation. It is surgery. Conservative is a surgery, the part of surgery. So we have to put all the restoration into the dry field, not to make any contamination of the cavity either during preparation or during insertion of the materials, because some bacteria or product of bacteria will release the bulb through the dentinal tubules and make the bulb damage. So we have to mandatory to apply rubber dam to make the tooth isolated from the fluid or saliva. Okay. Thank you for listening. Thank you for listening and السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. شكرا على الاستماع طبعا. وأي ملاحظة ممكن احنا مستعدين احنا نجاوب عليها. ممكن أطلنا شوية لأن الموضوع يحتاج اهتمام كامل، لأن هو الأساسيات في العمل بتاعنا اللي ممكن احنا إن شاء الله نبدو فيه الأسبوع الجاي، لأن البرنسبل هذا لازم تنعطي قبل باش على الأقل الأسبوع الجاي نبدو على الأقل نجيبو أدواتنا اللي قلنا لكم عليها من الأول وجبتها، هو الهاي سبيد هاند بيس والبيرات وستور الأسنان، ونبدو في العمل بتاعنا إن شاء الله مع المحاضرات اللي تمشي اون لاينز. وكان في اي موضوع يحتاج لإعادة ولا يحتاج ان احنا نلخصه فيه شوية، ممكن احنا ما عنديش مشكلة، وان شاء الله تكونوا موفقين يا رب في الكلام هذا. والسلام عليكم.